Get full access to over 10,000 episodes with your paid subscription. My Outdoor TV. Start your free trial today.
I picked up my first bow at 3 years old, and I don't remember a single moment since then that I didn't love this. From my first arrow, to my first deer, to my first world championship, my desire to be the best has only grown. Over the years, I've experienced the highest of highs. I've watched my dreams come true, but with that have come the lowest of lows, endless sacrifices, and a lot of hard work. Archery has given me so much, but the most important of all started when I was 10 years old and I saw her shoot for the first time. She was a little blonde-haired girl that to this day is the prettiest thing I've ever seen. Her name was Samantha Klein.
I grew up a little girl in a patch town in southwestern Pennsylvania, and my dad was a bow hunter. At the time, archery was simply a chance to spend time with my dad. I had no idea, 20 years later, how much impact it would have on my life. Over the years, I too have experienced the best this sport has to offer. I've done more than I ever thought possible, and I've been fortunate enough to do it all with my best friend. Looking back, almost all the memories, all the people, all the good things in my life, God has given me through a bow and arrow.
We're the Morgans, and this is Bowlife. Guys, welcome to season 3 of Bowlife. We are starting the year out this year in southern Colorado, one of my favorite places to elk hunt. Good friend Mike Williams' place. We were here a couple years ago and I shot a super nice bull, like 15 yards. And even though we're here really early and we know it's going to be tougher, we're hoping to do that again.
This is it. We are out hunting first night here in Colorado, and it's been like upper 80s all week, and we just got here and you can see some weather's moving in. Big rainstorms coming, temperatures dropping. It's absolutely perfect condition for getting these elk going because they've been moving right at dark, not bugling it at all. So we're just kind of flipping around. It's pretty early. We're just glassing and seeing if we can spot a good bull. Because they're not talking at all yet. So I'm just excited to be out here on this place where I know there's a bunch of big elk. I'm trying to find one. Hunting season is here though. I couldn't be more pumped.
Right before dark that night, we ended up getting on a big bull that was actually talking, and we kept moving in, got on a bull, realized it was a satellite bull when I cow called, and the big bull screamed just out of sight in the timber. He ended up pushing his cows right out in their lap, well within bow range, and was an absolute giant bull. But he kept his cows between us until dark right there in the aspens, and we really didn't get another bull fired up talking. We did find another big bull, had a lot of trash. We ended up spooking, trying to stalk, and it wasn't until the fourth day where we got the opportunity we had been looking for.
We hope you've enjoyed this free episode. To continue watching, start your free trial now.